don't go until you're praying to break even. Until stay.
Something that nobody knows about me is that I sleepwalk and I sing in my sleep. And also I read magazines from front to back. I guess because I'm not afraid to touch on topics that might be sensitive or, you know, touchy. So I've never been told not to do that. So I'm just going to continue and hope that my fans still continue liking my music. My favorite musician would definitely be Vince Gill. I think as a guitar player that he's just the best, hands down. And the music that I've been listening to lately is a lot of Jason Isbell, Holly Williams, Brandi Clark. Just music that tells stories and talks about real stuff. And it's just really, really exciting for me and very inspiring. Yes, I do love prank calling people. I've done that since I was a kid. And one time we were all sitting over at my friend's house and we couldn't think of anyone to prank call. So I just threw out my mom's phone number and I said, call my mom. So my friend Chris starts calling my mom on speakerphone and we're all sitting there. And after he gets through his whole spiel, my mom goes, Sunny, please stop doing this. It's too late. So everybody started laughing, and then she knew that it was me, obviously, or I was involved. So, watch out, because I might be prank calling you if I have your number. Yes, we did PledgeMusic.com for a portion of funds for my record. And I was a little nervous at first because I didn't know how it was going to work out. I didn't know, you know, will people actually pledge? We ended up going over the amount we needed for the pledge and above the percentage. And it was awesome. It was a great experience. And I did a lot of the, you know, social media stuff. And then my management company did a lot. The record label did a lot. And a lot of word of mouth. So it was a good experience for me. I have a lot of wonderful things that I've been blessed with, being able to do. So I don't just have one. I have obviously the Grand Ole Opry. Every single time I play there, it's like the first time again. And opening for Merle Haggard was amazing. I got to sit on stage with Vince Gill and Don Schlitz and Big Al Anderson and do a guitar pull with them. And that was an extremely high point of my life. It was like, bring your A game, girl. My answer to this is, you do not want to see me dancing. Damn near break, it always has. You don't go until you're praying to break even. I feel like a lot of the songwriting that I do is with co-writers, and a lot of those co-writers I've actually become friends with outside of the music business. So it's easy for me to open up in front of someone that I feel closer to just as a friend. So a lot of stuff is real and a lot of it is very therapeutic to actually get it out. So for me, that works. Well, actually, I did not write this song. My friends Brandi Clark, Shannon Wright, and Jesse Joe Dillon wrote it. And my producer brought it to me and was like, you have got to hear this. So he played it, and hands down, I just go, I want that song. It's perfect for what we need. And so I was lucky enough to stumble across that. And so thanks, girls, for writing it. And I think it's amazing, and I'm glad that I was able to record it. Well, a little known fact about Texans is that when we're born, we get a chip installed in us that makes us root for the Cowboys. So, yes, I do like the Cowboys, and I like their silver pants. But as far as dating an athlete, I don't think my husband would like that very much. So, I don't think there's going to be any athlete dating going on. So... You can find my music at iTunes, Amazon.com, Google Play Store. You can find it on my website at Walmart and Best Buy. So, and at shows, definitely at shows. So come on out, and I can't wait to meet y'all individually, and I hope to see you soon.